Our question is being received from Dallas, Texas, from USA. During the fasting, I could not control and I did intercourse with my wife and I did not ejaculate it. This is a very serious issue. First, we have to understand the month of Ramadan is something like we have to build our taqwa in ourselves. This is not something we let our nafs go to do whatever we can. We have to have a strong control of our mind in our heart, and this is the month of Allah that this is the only month that we can practice and to make ourselves and train ourselves to how to live a life in another 11 months. So for an example, there were the many cases during the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that many sahabas had a sex during the daytime, and they talk to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they complained about that. Then it was being abrogated, that then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, okay, you can do it, but you can do the intercourse after the iftar time, but not during the iftar time. So this is the mercy of Allah, that Allah finds us a way to make our life better. But now we are trying to make ourselves to put ourselves in a more trouble. So this month is to build a taqwa inside us. So we have to be careful what things we do and what trigger us and what is things that penetrate us to do something wrong. Like for example, during the fasting time, and we need to be careful with the, we should not look at our wives and while she is being naked and while she's taking a shower. So that will penetrate us, and it will open the desire inside us to go and have intercourse with her and fulfill our desire. So basically, this is our a month that we have to be very strong in this matter. But if someone has done that, this is really an extremely sin. Even though he did not ejaculate it, but he did the intercourse, but still this is his fasting is not valid anymore. So he has to pay the expiation, and he has to pay a kafara, and then he has to complete this fast after that, and he has to do sadqas, and there's a hadith about that. Either he has to fast for 60 days, and he has to feed like I think 60 or the 65 masakin or the needy people, and to pay the expiation. So when we have the mercy of Allah, that Allah gave us a chance, okay, you can between this time frame you should not be doing anything. But also it's a mercy of Allah that before it was not allowed, but then after that it's mercy of Allah that Allah said, okay, now you're allowed to do that. But after, once you had your iftari time, then you're allowed to do something. But still you cannot do allowed to do something even in a Ramadan. That becomes like a very severe sin. So even if someone has an intercourse and somebody did not ejaculate it, this is a very, very extreme sin. So he has to expiate and he has to repent. So he has to be careful thing. So basically we have to stay away from the things that would penetrate us, or that would make us open our desires to do more further in that action. So we have to be careful that.